Hi, I hope all of you are taking good care about yourself, your friends, your family, your relatives, people around you, our fellow citizens. Kindly keep on wearing a mask, use of sanitizers, soaps, twice bathing is very, very important. Boosting our immunity is also very important in this difficult time that we have been all facing since March 2020, when the coronavirus pandemic hit our country and of course the world. It was already there from before. So the central government, the state government has been implementing a lot of measures, a lot of rules, particularly to protect us. Kindly follow them and help them to bring all of us out of it. They're also boosting the economy through various means, various measures that they've been taking. I would definitely like to thank, first of all the corona warriors who have helped us in protecting us in this difficult time. And one more important reason to make this video is to answer a very, very important question of yours, that what about capital markets? Many people have that question, that fear in mind, ki boss, what should I do now? This corona pandemic has brought down the markets in the month of March. To take an example, being a market, first of all, remember that there will be ups and downs. And that's the time actually we go on investing and get the utmost advantage from these falling markets by buying at a lower level, and then when the market rises, because it's ultimately going to rise, it's like a roller coaster ride. Whenever we go to amusement parks, we go into a small car, there are tracks, the tracks go up, they go down, go up, they go down, simply meaning the markets also will move that way. And that's exactly what has happened over the past. Let's take a very recent example, as I was just quoting. In March, the Sensex, which is the primary index or the benchmark index of the Bombay Stock Exchange, was at a level of 38,140 points. So 38,140 points was on 2nd of March 2020. And since then, as I said, the corona pandemic slowly and gradually started seeping into the Indian economy. And that's when the markets also got impacted, and they fell down to a level of 25,981 points as on 23rd March. That is, in a matter of around 21 days or 20 days to be precise, 12,159 points, the markets came downwards. People definitely would have got frightened, that fear would have definitely seeped into their minds. But as I said, not panicking, not fearing the markets was the fundamental to it. Because as I said, as the markets fall, sometime or the other, the markets are going to rise, and that's exactly what has happened over the past. And this time also this happened. On 23rd of March, the markets were at a level of 25,981 points. And exactly 4 months later, that is on the 23rd of July 2020, just 4 to 5 days back, the markets again hit that initial level that was on 2nd of March, which was 38,140 points. So where it was, ultimately it came back to that level. Point being, if we would have just got frightened and panicked and exited the market by booking a loss, we would have probably not got our capital back, or at least our whatever the amount we had invested got back, getting back that amount. So point is, don't panic, remain invested, concentrate on your goal and not on the returns. Please don't run behind returns. Consistently investing into the markets is very important, and that is exactly what we all need to do. If you have liked this video, kindly do comment on it, subscribe to this channel, forward this video to others as well, and hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button to continuously receive notifications about the videos uploaded on this channel. Thank you. Stay safe. Stay healthy.